everyone. In this lesson, I will introduce you to rice leaf rollers. One of the three major pests of rice leaf rollers belong to the Pyralidae of Lepidoptera and are commonly known as leaf holders, a migratory pest of rice. The larvae of rice leaf rollers roll the leaf from the leaf margin to the frontal side to form a bract, which feeds on the upper epidermis and leaf flesh, leaving only the white lower epidermis, to form strips of white spots of varying length as the body grows. The larvae continue extending the bracts forward. Characteristic identification. The adult is about 10 mm long, with a wingspan of about 18 mm, yellowish-brown. The four wings are subtriangular, with two dark brown horizontal lines and a short dark brown horizontal line close to the anterior margin. The outer margin has dark brown broadband. The larvae are generally 5 instars and a few have 6 instars. Mature larvae are 14 to 19 mm long, with body color ranging from light yellow-green to yellow-green and turning orange-red when mature. Emergence pattern. Rice leaf rollers are migratory pests and cannot overwinter in northern rice areas, so the initial source of insects in most rice areas comes from the south. Adults are phototropic, tend to live in the shade, and prefer to lay eggs on young leaves. When the temperature is right and the humidity is high, the number of eggs laid is high. Mostly newly hatched larvae burrow into the heart leaves and infest them. After reaching the second instar, they roll the leaves into bracts and feed them. At the late budding stage, they can feed in the bracts of the spike. Most mature larvae leave the old bracts and pupate on the yellow leaves and ineffective tillering young leaves at the bottom of the rice bush. Rainy days and high humidity with lots of dew are conducive to rampant emergence. However, too much rain is detrimental to adult activity, egg attachment, and the survival of young larvae. Finally, the control method of rice leaf rollers. To control rice leaf rollers, we should harrow and compost the paddy fields early in spring to eliminate the source of overwintering insects. Choose insect-resistant varieties, strengthen field management, and dry the fields at the right time. You can also manually remove the insect bracts. Then natural enemies such as Trichogramma and paddy spiders can be used for control. Lastly, the moth eggs can be controlled by pesticides. During incubation, available pesticides, agritol, abamectin, chlorantraniliprole, thiamethoxam, emamectin benzoate, methoxyphenoside, dursban, and doxicarb, etc. Thank you for watching, and we will see you next time.